We're back to finish our weak acid strong base titration pH calculations. We are now past the equivalence point in region 4. Our question for this example is to calculate the pH when 30 milliliters of 0.10 molar sodium hydroxide is added to 25 milliliters of 0.10 molar acetic acid. Again, we have our change table set up here where we have calculated the initial millimoles of our weak acid and our strong base. And as we can see here, we have now surpassed the equivalence point, and I can tell that because my sodium hydroxide is now my excess reagent. I have excess sodium hydroxide left over. Notice my weak acid has now become my limiting reagent and is used up. I no longer have a buffer because I don't have the weak acid left over. Our pH is determined solely by the amount of excess sodium hydroxide we have in solution. So yes, we do form some of the basic salt at the end of our calculation. I'll talk about why that is not a factor at this point in our titration. Because we have excess strong base in solution, our pH is going to be determined purely by how much of that base is left over or unreacted. Sodium hydroxide dissociates in a 1-to-1 ratio, so our hydroxide concentration will be the same as sodium hydroxide concentration. And I'm calculating concentration because when we calculate pOH, we will need to use the concentration there. Remember that concentration is millimoles divided by our total volume. At this point in our titration, we have 25 milliliters of acid. We have now added 30 milliliters of base. And so our concentration of hydroxide is 0.009909, repeating. Again, keeping some extra digits for calculations. Our pOH will be the negative log of this value. That is 2.04139 with some extra digits. And then, of course, pH is going to be 14 minus that value. We would expect a high value because we have excess strong base in solution. And so it makes sense that our final pH is 11.96, two decimal places here because of two sig figs in concentration. Two final comments I want to make here. If you remember from our calculation at 0.3 at the equivalence point, when we formed our 2.5 millimoles of salt, that was able to produce a hydroxide concentration of 5.27 something something times 10 to the minus sixth molar. The point here is to illustrate that when we are calculating past the equivalence point, realize that we do have both sources of hydroxide in solution. Right, we still have the hydroxide from our salt, but compared to the hydroxide from the excess base, this value is so minimal it will not be a factor. If I asked for a volume close to the equivalence point, just past the equivalence point, this hydroxide from the salt might be a factor, but I will not ask for those volumes. And so anytime you're past the equivalence point, you can omit the contribution of the basic salt to our solution or to our pH. The other thing that I want to point out here is to recognize that when we calculated our pH in region 4 of our strong acid, strong base titration, our pH there was also 11.96. And that is because in both of these titrations, both the strong acid and the weak acid titration, we were past the equivalence point, meaning all that was left in solution was our strong base. We had the same amount of strong base in both. And so our pH is exactly the same value for both. We have the same setup and same pH value. Quick comment here, problem 14.22 in the textbook is a good practice problem for you. And I will finish up on our next video with some final slides with reference to weak acids and strong bases.